So hello guys and welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we will see the 8085 program to convert gray code into its equivalent binary number for an array of elements. So I hope you have already watched my previous video. There we have discussed how to convert gray code into binary code, right? But here we will convert a set of numbers from gray code to its binary code. That means we will apply the same method of conversion from gray to binary over an array of elements. So the main concept of conversion from gray to binary is the same as the previous video. So I suggest you to please watch out the previous video, otherwise you will not be able to understand today's video. And you can get that link from the I button. So how we converted gray code into its equivalent binary code? Let's consider an example like the number B. So this is 80 hex, right? So this is in gray code. Now if we convert it into binary code, then what we'll get? This one will come first, then 1s or 0 is equals to 1, 1s or 0 is equals to 1, similarly 1s or 0 is equals to 1, and all the bits will be 1 in the same way. So this is the binary code. This was the logic, but how we did it in the assembly language program? We have consider the main data and we have rotated this data towards right by 1 bit. Then we have performed the XOR operation between the actual data and the rotated data. That means let this content is in the accumulator. So the accumulator contains the actual data, right? And we have rotated this data towards right by 1 bit. So we have got some rotated data. Okay, this is a rotated part of the accumulator. Now we have performed XOR operation between these two data, right? So we got some result, right? Then again we have rotated this data. That means whatever data is rotated, we will again rotate this data towards right. So we will again get some data, and again the XOR operation will be performed between these two data. Then again we will got some result. So all these steps were being performed 7 times, right? I have already discussed about it very clearly in the last video, right? So this was for a single data, but when we are given a array of data, that means let's say there are 5 elements in an array. Okay, so 5 is the count of the elements in the array. So if we start inputting all the data from C050 hex address, okay, so first of all we will input this count of the element from C050 hex address. Then from C051 we will input this data, from 52 we will input this data, similarly here C053 this data, and so on, right? So we will input a data and convert it into its gray code, and simultaneously we will store that data into some other set of memory locations. Let's say we have started storing all the data, that is all the outputs, from C500 hex address. Okay, so the binary number of this gray code is stored here. Then the binary number of this gray code is stored in the next memory location, that is C501 hex address. Okay, and so on until we have encountered the last data. Now we will write its code in 8085 microprocessor. So first of all, what we will do, we will input the count of the total number of elements. So I am inputting this from C050 hex address, right, as we have specified here. Then we also need to initialize another set of memory location from this address. So as we have used HL register pair for this one, that is from C050 hex, so we can use DE register pair starting with the memory location C500 hex address. So for that we will do LXI D comma C500 hex address. That means the DE register pair will be pointing to the memory location C500 hex address. Now we have inputted the first data, that is the count of the array, from C050 hex. So we will store that in some register like C. Okay, so C contains the total number of elements. Now we will start inputting all the elements one by one. For that, INXH. This will input the first data into the memory. Then we will move this data into the accumulator so that it can be stored, right? Now we have got our first data. So what we need to do? We need to convert this into binary number. And how we will do that? By performing these sets of operations 7 times. That means we need to perform the operation for 7 times. For that, we will initialize another register like B with 07 hex. Okay, then we will rotate this data towards right, as we have discussed in the previous video, that is rotate accumulator towards right. Then the XOR operation will be performed with the content of memory, and you can see that the memory contains the actual data, right? That is 0B hex only. So the content of accumulator, that is the rotated data, is being XORed with the actual content, that is the content of memory. So XRAM, right? As we have rotated the data and performed the XOR operation, now we will decrement the value of B. So it will be DCRB, and this will be repeated until the content of B becomes 0. So for that checking, we will use a JNZ loop. That means jump if the content of B is not equal to 0. So where this loop will jump? This loop will jump to this location, right? We have already discussed about it in the previous video. Let's say this is loop 1. Okay, so with these steps, we have got the binary number of the first data into the accumulator, right? Now we will store that data into this location, and we have already initialized DE register pair with this address, right? So what we will do is we will store the content of accumulator into this location, that is the location pointed by DE register pair. So we have stored the data here. Now we will implement the location of DE register pair so that it points to the next location. So for that, we will perform INXD. So till now we are done with the first data. Now we will move to the second data, right? So for moving to the second data, see here, the register C contains 05 hex, that is the total number of elements in the array. So we will decrement the content of C, that is we will perform DCRC, right? Now we also need to check whether this content is equals to 0 or not. That means we have reached to the end of the array or not. So for that, we will use a JNZ loop, right? Let's say this is loop 2. So if the content of C is not equals to 0, it means what? It means that we will again move to the next location. We will fetch that data and convert it into binary number, right? So this JNZ loop 2 will go to which location? This JNZ loop 2 control will go to this location. Why? Because after decrementing the content of C, if this is not equal to 0, then we will fetch the next data. So we can fetch that data by INXH instruction. Then again, all the same operation will be performed, right? So this loop will continue until the content of C becomes 0. That means we have reached to the end of the array. Once we have reached to the end of the array, that means we have encountered all the elements. Then the process is completed and we will execute the halt statement. Okay, so this is how we will convert gray code into binary number in an array of elements. So I hope you understood this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel to support us, and see you in the next video. Thank you.